Hi, I'm Rachel Nussbaum from the OTC Markets Corporate Services team. I'm here today with Mark Emalfarb, CEO, and Matthew Jones, CCO of Dyadic International, which trades on our OTCQX Best Market under ticker symbol DYAI. Welcome, both of you.
Thanks, Rachel.
Thanks, Rachel.
To start off, Dyadic International was founded in 1979 and began trading on OTCQX in 2014. What has made OTCQX the best option for your company?
It provides us with a platform that's more cost-effective than a listed company on a Nasdaq or a New York Stock Exchange.
Interesting. And as a global biotech, can you tell me what Dyadic has been doing recently?
Sure. In the last 12 months, it's been really busy. We've been able to enter into a number of research collaborations, big pharma and biotech. Their press releases, which we've announced recently too. I think the platform is proving itself to really challenge the established platform, which is how you manufacture biologics today, whether it be for vaccines, whether it be for antibodies, enzymes, peptides. There's a very established platform which big pharma have got very comfortable with, but that platform actually has a very low productivity and it's very expensive and it's very aged now. Our platform is proven to be quicker, faster, cheaper, we believe better, and these relationships I've mentioned are further proving the platform forwards.
That's very impressive. Can you elaborate more on the competitive landscape and what sets Dyadic International apart?
I think as big pharma really struggles with the changing reimbursement and the landscape of how payers are actually rewarding the hard R&D efforts, some of the basics haven't changed for many years, and one of those is the cell line in which you use to express your therapeutic. And I think what we're offering here is a real challenge to the establishment. We're offering a real disruptive technology. It's been proven for 20 plus years in the industrial setting. And we're applying that parent technology now to the biologics world in human and animal health. And so the research collaborations that we've started are now going on to deeper relationships, which we're really excited about.
It sounds like you have a lot going on. So what's next for Dyadic International?
Well, after the sale of our industrial biotech business for $75 million to DuPont, we've transformed the business to focus on biopharmaceuticals, where we expect to change the game in the way drugs are developed and produced. Be able to produce them faster at a lower cost and make them more affordable, more accessible to the patients while reducing the burden on the healthcare system. And in so doing, we brought on two board members that have vast experience in big pharma. Dr. Aaron DuBose is one of our directors, been on board for about a year and a half, comes from Pfizer after 34 years of heading up their biologic group, is one of the senior leaders. And recently, Dr. Barry Buckland came on board, and he was at Merck for 29 years in a similar role where he headed up biologics there in the vaccine and biologics group. So we're aiming really here to make a difference. We want to reduce the cost of healthcare. We want to make it more affordable, more accessible. And as you know, here in New York recently and across the country with influenza and the problems there, we've actually been developing what we think is a better way to make lower cost flu vaccines that perform better, that will provide better protection for our population.
Sounds like Dyadic is up to some really big things, and we look forward to seeing what happens in the future. Thank you so much for shedding some light on Dyadic International's story.
Thank you
for having us. Thanks, Rachel.